Hi friends, this is Surojit Ray here. Today I shall be sharing my research findings around an intriguing concept known as auto writing. Some of you may have heard this term before. Simplistically understood, in auto writing, a person starts writing automatically without he being in any control of what he is writing. Sounds unbelievable, isn't it? But yes. That is how auto-writing is. When an auto-writer gets into an auto-writing session, he just picks up the pen and starts writing random stuff. After the auto-writing session is over, the auto-writer has no recollection of how he wrote, what he wrote. It is said that in auto-writing, either the subconscious mind of the auto-writer or a spirit energy, as the case may be, takes control over the auto-writer, and that is when he starts writing. Auto-writing is a common technique used by people with psychic abilities to connect with the spirit world. Yes, through the medium of auto-writing, certain psychic experts claim to be messengers between the spirit world and the living world, which is the world in which we live. Scientists, psychiatrists, and psychologists have a completely different take on auto-writing. They believe this happens owing to a concept known as ideomotor effect. Ideomotor effect is a phenomenon where a person makes movements unconsciously, that is, without being aware of what he is doing. So the phenomenon is explained by scientific minds as a very high stage of stupor, where the person momentarily either loses sync with his conscious thinking or possibly pretends to be doing so. In fact, scientific researchers have been able to successfully prove that quite a few instances of alleged auto-writing were fake and fabricated. One of them was the famous auto-writing session by the wife of Arthur Conan Doyle. It was proven conclusively that she was faking. Psychiatrists treat auto-writing as a bout of hallucination, possibly emanating from larger psychiatric disorders such as schizophrenia. So clearly, there are two extreme schools of thought around the concept of auto-writing today. Believers see it as the only channel available to communicate with the dead or the spirit world. And non-believers shrug it off as a psychiatric disorder. My research was to understand the concept of auto-writing by staying somewhere on the middle of the line. While I would not want to blindly trust the concept of auto-writing, the probing nature within me also did not want to shrug it off as mere hallucination just because teachers of psychiatry connoted it to be so. I was in search of a concrete reason either to believe it or disbelieve it. In the course of my research, I met up with 10 auto writers, some of whom were very popular. I also met up with 2 leading psychiatrists, a paranormal expert, and 10 subjects, meaning people who had taken recourse to auto writing to connect with the dead. Of course, I would not name any of them in this video for anonymity reasons. So I picked up a fairly large population of people to research on. A common observation that came out from all the 10 subjects I interviewed and who had used auto-writing to connect with their dead loved ones was that all 10 of them could successfully connect with the dead through their auto-writers. But whatever the auto-writers wrote on behalf of the dead in each of these cases was more generic than specific. They came up only with generic information from the dead. To give an example, wherever the subject wanted specific facts or details from the dead person, like, for example, the password to a locker or a bank account, or maybe details of financial investments that had been made by the dead person and which were unknown to his loved ones, or who was the murderer of the dead person. The auto-writers failed to get any answers to such pointed questions. They failed miserably on this count. In defense, all the auto writers in these 10 cases claimed that they were under the complete influence of the soul and they wrote only what the soul wanted to convey of his own free will through their medium. Even if the auto writer so desired, he could not ask pinpointed questions to the soul. So this was their defense behind getting generic information from the souls as opposed to something specific and concrete. While this finding does tempt the scientific side in me to believe that this was indeed ideomotor effect, however, what also intrigues me is that how could all the 10 auto writers unanimously experience exactly the same phenomenon in 10 different situations and at 10 different times? The tricky thing was that all these 10 auto writers whom I interviewed separately at different points of time for these 10 specific cases explained what they felt during the auto writing session in the same language as each other. Their feelings were the same. Their explanations were more or less the same. Their findings were pretty identical. And most importantly, their clients could completely correlate the information they wrote on the piece of paper in each case with that of the respective dead person. This was not just random stuff which they were writing on paper. What was written in each case did have something to do with the concerned dead person the auto writer was claiming to connect with. The auto writer never personally knew the dead person he or she was connecting with in the auto writing session. Still, he or she could write certain details about the dead person with significant accuracy during the auto writing session. How was all of this possible? Was this all a coincidence that the auto writer got most of his or her writing exactly matched with existing facts about the dead person? Or were all these 10 auto writers patients of a psychiatric ailment? If yes, how did they all hallucinate so close to reality in 10 different sessions for 10 different souls and at 10 different times? Interesting, right? But pause. Let me now argue on the scientific side. If this were all so true and perfect, why could the auto writer not get the locker password from the dead person? Why could the auto writer not find out who murdered the dead person? Why don't spirits share specific facts like these? If spirits really speak through an auto writer, well then, they should also be sharing these important and specific factual details like, for example, a password or their murderer's name. No reason for a spirit to hold these back. Why would they not want to share such information when they know that the people they have left behind on earth are so keen to know about these details? So well, there are more questions here than answers. But one thing seems a near certainty. You cannot blindly write off every case of auto writing as a coincidence or a well-planned fraud or a mental ailment. There is definitely something more to it than what simply meets the eye. In fact, I have heard of a few cases in the US where psychic experts could touch belongings of a missing person and give a description of where their dead bodies were hidden and how their murderers actually looked like. So much so that a sketch of the murderer could be made in most cases based on their descriptions. Surprisingly, most of these cases were cracked successfully by the police, and the guidance of the psychic expert proved to be almost fully accurate. So was this all false? Was this all an advanced state of hallucination which eventually proved to be correct? Well, we really don't know. One thing that is known though is that many provincial police departments in the US now do officially go to psychic experts to solve difficult murder and missing person cases when evidence is not readily available with them, and the success rate of these psychic experts is pretty high. Now coming to the most interesting part of this video, what is my analysis on this topic? What is my conclusion based on the research which I did? I shared with you findings both for and against the concept. Now, what is my view on this topic? Is auto writing real or is it mere ideomotor effect? Well, the answer to this question lies in the fact that I am a firm believer in afterlife or life after death, reincarnations and the powers of the subconscious mind. Being a hypnotherapist, I know how infinitely powerful our subconscious mind is. I have also handled a couple of cases of reincarnation and know the accuracy with which these people blurted out details of their prior lives, all of which was then proven to be factually correct. So I do believe in looking beyond the obvious and to also believe in things that cannot be seen. Air and electricity also cannot be seen, right? But we do know they exist. So I would say that I would give auto writing my vote of support. I would be more inclined to believe that it exists and works rather than believing that it is hallucination in every single case. While a few auto writers may be hoax and some auto writing experiences may have been fabricated with fraudulent intent, however, writing off every single instance of auto writing as unscientific and hence fake may not be the correct approach in my view. But I have still not given you the exact reason, the precise reason why I would want to believe in auto writing. I kept the reason for the last. The best is always supposed to be shared at the last. The only and only reason why I would be inclined to believe in auto writing is a book by the name Laws of the Spirit World. This book has been written by a rich old Parsi lady. Her name is Khorshed Bhavnagri. This book was written more than 35 years back. And can you believe that this was fully written through auto writing? Meaning, a couple of dead people used the medium of Khorshed Bhavnagri to write this book through auto writing. Unfortunately, Khorshed Bhavnagri is no more amongst us today. This book gives the most realistic and vivid possible explanation of afterlife, meaning what happens to a person after death. Different religions have given different philosophies about afterlife. However, the bottom line of all religions on this subject remains the same, just that they have adopted different paths to arrive at the same destination. Does not really matter whether you call it Swarg or Jannat or Paradise, does it? Now, coming back to this phenomenal book, one of the key messages shared in this book is that religion survives only till we are alive. Once dead, the journey is the same for one and all. Whether you are a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian or a Parsi or anybody else, doesn't matter. The journey is the same for one and all in the afterlife. There are quite a few books written on afterlife, and I had the privilege of reading most of them. I also had the privilege of reading through all the available spiritual literature on afterlife as given in Hinduism, Christianity, Islam, Sikhism, Jainism, Buddhism, and Zoroastrianism. While the base conclusion of all religions on this topic is unanimously similar, the terminologies used in this context vary from religion to religion. As I read this book titled Laws of the Spirit World, I soon realized that what Khorshed Bhavnagri had written in the book was the most authentic and well-researched explanation on the concept of afterlife. It felt like this book unanimously bound all religions together and gave the most elaborate possible explanation on how karma and afterlife actually works. I can strongly vouch for this statement of mine, having been a researcher on this topic for 20 long years. Just to provide you a brief background behind this book, Khurshed Bhavnagri unfortunately lost both her young sons in a tragic car accident. Both these souls were true jewels, and they had attained salvation or moksha after that particular death in the accident. However, seeing the plight of their distraught old parents whom they had left behind, these two souls had to reach out to their parents on earth through the medium of an auto writer. Khurshed Bhavnagri found great peace in connecting with her dead sons through auto writing. In fact, this became her only reason to stay alive on earth after the irreparable loss she and her husband had faced. Eventually, Khurshed Bhavnagri became an auto writer herself, and through her medium, her two sons shared the biggest secret ever known around karma and afterlife through this book titled Laws of the Spirit World. So this is the only book I know which is available and which has been written by spirits or the dead through auto writing. Every other book I know has been written by a living person. Interesting, right? Well, please do not treat me as a marketing agent of this book. Let me clearly clarify here. This book has already sold millions of copies worldwide after famous Bollywood dance guru Shyamak Davar republished this book. Shyamak was known to Khurshed Bhavnagri. Reading this book changed Shyamak's life forever. Hence, he wanted the book to reach the world at large. That's where he took that extra effort of getting it republished. Friends, I've been lucky to have read a little more than the normal man. Yes, miles to go before I sleep, and the more I read, the humbler I feel. But there's no exaggeration here as I say this, just take my words, friends. This book is second on my list of most revered books, most respected books. Bhagavad Gita comes first in my life, and this book comes second. Yes, I mean what I say. That's how great this phenomenal book is. Khurshed Bhavnagri was a normal sansarik Parsi lady who had not read any spiritual scriptures before the death of her sons. She wrote this book within a couple of years of their dying. If her auto writing was fake and she had written this book reading through other material available on this subject, by no stretch of imagination could she have got so much depth and knowledge within a couple of years. It's just impossible. Also, what all she has written in this amazing book beautifully amalgamates everything available in all the religions that I have read so far on afterlife. And it took me 20 long years to read all of this. This book does not hover around any one particular religion. Neither is it a pirated copy-paste of knowledge readily available in some other book. So, in a nutshell, it would have been impossible for Khurshed Bhavnagri to master so much in a span of 2 years and then pen this book herself, if at all for a moment we were to doubt that there was some fraud committed by her while writing this book. Even the most learned person on earth would easily take 2 years just to type or pen this exhaustive book, assuming all the knowledge in the world on this subject was readily sitting in his or her brains. So for sure, Khurshed Bhavnagri would have written this book only through auto writing. It was practically impossible for her to pen this book herself in a time frame of 2 years and then claim this was written through auto writing. As claimed by Khurshed Bhavnagri, she just kept writing what she was being made to write in the auto writing sessions by her two sons. She would do it every day, simply for the joy of connecting with her lost sons. No other book on earth, yes, I mean it, no other book on earth gives a more authentic explanation of afterlife than what I read in this book. You have to read it to understand how deep it is. The book has case studies around karma. It is spine-chilling, to say the least, to read through all that has been explained in this great book. It could change the perception of a person towards life and karma forever. No exaggeration here. This is the only book I ask all my counseling clients to read. This book has already impacted millions of lives. Now is your chance to pick it up. Please read it and take my words. You will remember Surojit Ray for a lifetime for having recommended you this book. If you read this book, you do not need to read anything else on this subject. The book is available online on Amazon, Flipkart, and all other e-portals. It is also available for Kindle readers. In fact, Hindi, Gujarati, Marathi, and South Indian translations of this book are also now available. So popular is this book. So only and only because of Khurshed Bhavnagri and her life-transforming book titled Laws of the Spirit World, I would believe that auto-writing is true and real. For the non-believer, auto-writing is mere hallucination. But for a believer, auto-writing could gift him with all the motivation and hope necessary to live life bravely after the loss of a loved one. So, in conclusion, while I would give a heads up to the concept of auto-writing, I would also say here that take recourse to it only when extremely necessary. Auto-writing is no fun. In fact, I would hope and pray that you never have to take help of auto-writing. Further, not every auto-writer is true and genuine. Go through the credentials of the auto-writer in great detail before choosing one. You need a different level of enlightenment and connect with the spirit world to be good enough to be an auto-writer. Not everybody can be an auto-writer. Well, the next question. Am I an auto-writer? Sorry friends, Surojit Ray is not an auto-writer. I am a hypnotherapist, motivational speaker, counselor, coach and mentor. But I am inquisitive and keep on exploring in depth areas not frequently explored by the world. I believe that there is a lot beyond the obvious, and I am an avid researcher in some of these areas. That is where I ended up researching on auto-writing. So, do for sure read Laws of the Spirit World, written by Khurshed Bhavnagri. Does not matter which religion you belong to as you read this book. Remember, your religion binds you only till you breathe. The moment you are dead, the journey is the same regardless of religion, caste, creed, and community. Trust you enjoyed this video and it gave you a nice perspective around auto-writing and afterlife. Do like the video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel titled Karma Cosmos Talks if you have not already done it. Also, please hit the bell icon so that you can receive future notifications from my channel. The bell icon is available below the video. And leave a comment in the comment section of this video. Friends, I am a traveler on a never-ending journey. On my YouTube channel, you shall find a lot of such interesting stuff. Stuff which very few others speak about and research on. So, if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do so ASAP. That will inspire me to make many more such videos. God bless you all. Wishing you a wonderful, fulfilling and happy life ahead. Thank you so much for watching this video.